Forget the Democratic Party. Forget the Republican Party. Let's talk about the anger party. It's arguably the biggest phenomenon of this election season. Donald Trump and Bernie Sanders have both tapped into the discontent in the country. Many other candidates are trying to. But I want to ask if the press has been late to it, late to understanding it. Joining me now, Scottie Nell Hughes, a chief political correspondent for USA Radio Networks and a Donald Trump surrogate. And Anna Kasparian, the co-host of The Young Turks, the progressive radio and talk show on YouTube and elsewhere. Let me ask you both about this theory. But before I do, let me take a look at both what Trump and Sanders have said about their anger.
I'm very angry because our country is being run horribly, and I will gladly accept the mantle of anger.
I do not have a super PAC. I do not want Wall Street's money. I'll rely on the middle class and working families for my campaign contribution.
I have a question.
I'm angry at stupidity. I'm angry at incompetence.
Senator Sanders called him weak, disappointing.
I'm angry about a lot of things, and I won't be angry for long, because once we straighten it out, I'm a very happy person.
Let me try out a theory on both of you. Anna, you first. Many journalists, many members of the media are deaf to the frustration in the country, maybe because journalists, at least major media outlets, tend to be paid more than the average American, or because they live in big urban cities instead of in the heartland. What do you think of that theory, Anna?
Well, I think that it's true, especially of establishment media, to be completely honest with you, because the same types of components that corrupt our politicians, I think, also corrupt mainstream media. So it's really difficult for mainstream, let's say, cable outlets to talk about things like income inequality, wealth inequality, when the advertisers that are funding their shows are the same corporations that want to ensure that the same system continues. So I think when people watch digital media or new media, they get a completely different message. They focus on the issues that matter or resonate more with the constituency.
Scottie, I know you have a different political perspective, but do you buy into that argument?
Well, she makes some very good points, but honestly, I disagree, because in journalism, we know if it bleeds, it leads. And we're not just talking about the physical. You know, when we're $19 trillion in debt, when we have 94 million people out of the workforce right now, we see terrorism issues not only abroad, but here at home. Those are the stories that are leading our headlines. And so a journalist has to have their head completely in the sand if they don't realize that that is what people are watching, and the ratings show that those types of headlines make it. So I actually think journalists do know about the anger. If anything, they've not necessarily tried to feed it, but haven't done anything to definitely try to put the warm and fuzzy stories as their headline.
Certainly for reporters who are on the campaign trail, actually interviewing voters, I think they are tapped into the sentiments in the country. I think it's harder maybe if you're in New York or LA. I'm sorry, Anna, I think you were going to jump in there. What were you going to say?
I just wanted to make a statement about how a lot of the issues that matter the most to the electorate don't get covered at all. So let me give
you
a quick example of that.
Yeah.
Student loan debt is one of them. That is impacting our economy in one of the most negative ways imaginable. And we're sitting here having discussions about immigration and building walls. Right now, if you focus on the actual numbers, and this is according to Pew Research, immigration from Mexico is below net zero. What does that mean? That we have more Mexican immigrants leaving the country right now than coming in. And instead of focusing on issues that actually matter to millennial voters, for instance, we're focusing on non-issues in the country. The fear-mongering about Muslims and terrorism. Go ahead,
Scottie. Tell you this. There's more. I hate to tell you this. There's more in this world than just millennials. And I'm sorry. I agree. College debt's a big issue.
Uh-huh.
But when people are actually scared for their lives, that is the headline right there. So I agree. And it also looks at party lines. But I think across the board, both parties right now have let their constituencies down. And the media is just sitting there telling the stories. I mean, I'm sorry. If there was a terrorist action that happened in the United States and they let off with college debt, I would consider that media outlet to be a complete joke.
Okay, so you think that our current economic situation in the United States is not a big deal? You'd rather fearmonger about non-existent threats inside the United States as opposed to focusing on the issues that are burdening our economy. And by the way, student loan debt impact students. It also impacts you, and it impacts our economy, because how are millennials supposed to contribute to our economy when we're burdened with student loan debt, when we're dealing with a system that's corrupt, when 62 richest people in the world own more wealth than the bottom 3.5 billion people in the world? How are you going
to
talk to me about, these issues don't matter?
I don't want to play rough,
especially
but I do think it's worth
her.
I do think it's worth pointing out that when we talk about anger, what we're hearing, I think, in this conversation, different reasons to be dissatisfied with where the country is. Different reasons. And this is why sometimes when we watch
That's
a Democratic
right.
debate and a Republican debate, it feels like we're on two different planets because of the two different topics or different concerns. Unfortunately, I'm coming up against a very hard break, but I appreciate you both being here this morning. Thank you.